Hi everyone, it's great to see you. Today we're going to be doing some of the cold weather gardening chores that need to get done. And one of those is to make sure that I have some cuttings of my coleus that I can keep going inside throughout the winter. Now, about a week and a half ago, we had an announcement that we were going to have our first freeze. So I quick ran out and took some of those cuttings. So I have some inside already. But now I'm like, oh, the coleus are really starting to look kind of sad. If there's anything else that I want to do with them, I need to get that done now. So the first thing I did was I took a walk around the yard to see if we have any seeds that have set on for the coleus. Now, throughout the season, I tend to pinch those off so that the plant's energy doesn't go into making seeds, but that it just continues to leaf out and look like this beautiful coleus plant. However, I let a few go, and you can see that they're right here. They're not completely dried out yet. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna pinch these off and then put them somewhere to continue drying for the next couple weeks. But I do want to save them if at all possible. Each one of these little seed stalks here has a ton of seeds on it. Actually, if I planted all of these and they all took, I probably wouldn't even need to take any cuttings. So let me just do that. When you pinch any of your coleus off, it's really, really easy. Literally, it's just like a little pinch and snap. They come right off like that. And then just put them in a storage container. I think it's just those four right there. This one is here, but it hasn't dried. I'll take it. Okay, now I'm ready to start getting some little clippings. So here we have a coleus. I mean, you can just really tell, oh, it starts to drop its leaves, everything. It's just end of the season, what can you say? And this is really probably a little bit too far past to take some good cuttings from. As we're walking around to look at all the coleus to find the best ones to take cuttings of, I have to point out my beautiful purple hydrangea here. Look at that color. It is just such a strong hydrangea. It holds on to its petals and it keeps the saturated color so late into the season. So excited about this one. We've had a lot of evenings that have gone down to the 40s. So the coleus really start to show that by getting all these dark spots on them. This one actually looks probably better than most of the others. I'll show you some that don't look good. So you wanna walk around your yard if you're at this point in the season here and find your most protected coleus that aren't showing the weather as much. And those are the ones that you're going to take the clippings from. So this one's in my back corner. I find that this one stayed pretty good. And then I'm gonna take you up on the deck. The ones on the deck seem pretty sheltered too, but other areas in the yard, not so much. When you take a cutting of this, you want to make sure that you take a big enough cutting that you have quite a lot that will be under the water that you are going to put this in when you take it inside to put it in a vase. So I'm going to look at one of these. This one looks like it's in pretty good shape, and take maybe 6 inches where I just pinch the bottom here and snap it off just like that. It doesn't have to be a perfect snap, but this is a nice stalk here that I'll be able to put in water, and it's starting to rain on us. So we're going to be working very, very quickly. I'm gonna take a few more little pinchings off of this plant. Makes you go real fast when it starts to rain. Looking for those that are the least damaged. Way in the back, we have a Kong coleus here. This piece looks pretty good too, so I'm just gonna grab that. Okay, let's go up to the deck. I keep walking around the yard and finding more things that I just have to show you. And one of them is Froggy. So Froggy here has this fabulous fall foliage color that it is unlike any of my other hydrangeas that way to have it turn this deep burgundy. So another reason I love Froggy the hydrangea. Now these coleus are a lot more of a delicate type of coleus, just the smaller leaves, the little branches are much more delicate. I find that these are harder to root and harder to prep to get to root. So I'm gonna take a bunch of them and then hope that as you see me prepare these, they all don't fall apart. You could do this with scissors too. That certainly would work. And the plant might like you more if you did it that way. These are still such a pretty color. I think this might have been my favorite. And you know what? The thing with taking your cuttings here is if it doesn't work well and they don't root well, your local nursery will be happy to have you back to sell you some more next year. I just love how this arrangement ended up looking. These still look so healthy. I'm gonna take these from the back in case they don't keel over this tonight. Hopefully it'll still look pretty good. The colors of these are beautiful. Now, when you take these in as cuttings, don't be surprised if the colors change. Outside, in the sunlight, in the warmth, that's where you get your best color for your coleus. The idea with the clippings that you take for inside is just to keep them alive through the winter. So you're going to have to lower your expectations on your coleus. Alive is good. Oh, took the whole thing. Okay, let's head inside and prep these. So here I am with the cuttings that I took about a week and a half ago. They've just been sitting here on my nice sunny counter, and they actually look like they're doing really well. Almost all of them have started to root. Let me see, I'll just grab one up here. What you're looking for are these tiny little roots that are starting in the bottom. I did not dip these in rooting hormone. I literally ran out, grabbed them, and stuck them in some glasses. So you can see I actually have some drinking glasses here. I like to have a clear container that I'm putting these into because I want to peek in and see their root growth all the time. And the plants probably aren't as happy if I'm lifting them out. You can use any vase, any container that you have, of course. I actually ended up going to Home Goods and buying, they had sets of shot glasses for $6.99 for six of them. And I loved the size. I thought they were really cute. We'll probably really never use them for drinking, but they're going to be perfect for taking clippings of plants in them. So now I'm gonna add to these and get our new cuttings ready. So here we have our new cuttings. What I'm gonna do is go through these, and when you bring them inside, you want to check them over for hitchhikers, like the grasshopper that I accidentally brought in with the others a couple weeks ago. That was a surprise. See, you really don't want, of course, any bugs coming in with you. These look pretty good, you know, but you just take a moment. It's totally worth it to look at them. And then they don't need all these leaves, of course. So I am going to pluck off all of the bottom leaves. And for those coleus that are more delicate, you need to be a little more careful when you do this. So I'm just gonna leave the top, and I'm gonna shorten this one just a little bit. So this one looks like it's ready to go. I'm gonna put my pile of, these are all set to be put in water right over here. If this happens, you can still save the top part. Probably means I was going a little too quickly. I'm gonna grab some scissors here, actually. It's like a giant bowl of salad. I do not believe coleus are edible though, so don't take that as you should try it as a salad. They really are just so pretty. This one, surprisingly, is really hard for me to get cuttings from, and I don't particularly know why, but whenever I did this the last couple weeks ago, like, I kept breaking it, so I'm trying to be very careful. So far, so good. We took a lot of cuttings here. We're gonna have a lot of coleus plants. Don't look at that one. So that
actually was very therapeutic. It's a little bit like shelling peas. You just sort of get into a rhythm. I have all of these leaves that I plucked off. So I am just going to dispose of those. And there's a giant grasshopper in there. 1 second. Okay. Grasshopper is back outside. I think there's something about the neon green coleus that they just blend so well into this coleus. That I think was the only hitchhiker that we had. Let me get rid of these. I did find a couple more seed pods. There's not a ton of seeds on these, but I'm gonna add them to my container if I can remember what I did with my container. Okay, these are now ready to be added to whatever vase you have, whatever container. Now, they suck up a lot of water, especially at the beginning, but even throughout the winter, you need to be checking these regularly. You also want to make sure, and this is really why we took all those lower leaves out, you don't want leaves sitting in the water. They will rot, your plants will die. So make sure that the leaves are sticking out above the top. Make a cute little arrangement. And then if you find that they start to sprout a little growth underwater that's not roots, take it off. Or when you go to change the water, you're probably gonna wanna change the water about weekly. If you find like a dead leaf fell into the water, get rid of it. You don't want any debris, any other organic matter in that water. It will mold and rot and make it not a happy living condition for your coleus. Okay, so I have quite a few coleus cuttings here. Right now, they look good. There will be some that don't make it. And if that happens, you don't panic. You're happy with the ones that do make it. You do want to put them near some sun. So if you know whether your coleus prefers more shade or sun, that's fine. Indoor light is going to be a little bit different. We have shorter days with our, you know, just with the winter daylight. So I put them near a window or near a skylight so that they get some sun. It will change their color a bit, but that's okay. Now, I put some stalks of the same kind, more than one in each glass, not all of them, but in a couple. You can do that, especially at the beginning where their roots are not intertwined. However, they are either going to root well and then their root mass will just grow together and you'll have like one coleus here. The idea is we took lots of cuttings because we want lots of different plants. So basically, I need to go buy more little glasses or find other glasses around the house that in the first week or so, I can separate these out because each cutting will be a separate plant. Their roots are going to start to intertwine. They will be this big bundle and you won't want to hurt the plant by pulling them apart. So either be like, okay, I just ran out of glasses and these are all going to grow as one, or be prepared to split them shortly afterwards. Here are the seeds that I bought inside. So let me show you what I'm going to do with these. You want your seeds to be really, really well dried. So I'm going to put them on a white paper plate. That's so I can see those seeds really, really well. And then I'm going to put them in a very dry spot. So for me, that's going to be in the garage. Right now out there, I have my caladium bulbs driving. Right now out there, I have my caladium bulbs drying, and I'm just gonna put these right next to them. I know it's a safe, dry spot, warm enough. And if you look real closely at this, you can see these little dark specks here. Those are the seeds. They look almost like sesame seeds in size. So I just want them to really, really dry up. Some of these might be too fresh.
But I have some that are the dark there. They'll be fine as long as I give them a little bit more time to dry. So this just needs to sit out there. I'll check on them in a couple weeks. The good thing with seeds is we're not in a hurry here. We can't plant these till spring. So you can leave them in that dry spot just to dry for months if you want. So I'm just gonna leave these and see what happens. These are all the neon green coleus, which is my favorite. I use that most frequently, so I'm thrilled to get any seeds for these. I think the color of these are beautiful even inside, and that they will keep me going through the winter. Looking forward to planting them outside. I'll give you some updates on these as we go along. If one of your coleus does send up a spike of seeds, I would pinch that off. We want right now our main emphasis for these plants is to put all their energy into the root growth. So they don't need to put on seeds. You collected seeds if you wanted seeds. You can also go online and purchase seeds if you want seeds. This is just if you want to keep your own coleus going through the winter, and then in the spring, transfer them out. So good luck. Go out there quickly before it freezes if you're in zone 6B. If you're a little warmer, you might have a little bit more time here. And get your coleus clippings ready, because it's so important to keep that feeling of spring and hope for next season going throughout the winter. Thanks so much for joining me, and I'll see you in the next video.